what to do, he said that.
All right, here we go with a fun little ditty to warm us up. You know, you gotta shake it up a little bit. Okay, let's get all our stuff set. All right, I'm moving around 65 RPMs. I have light resistance on the wheel. I have a water bottle full ready. I have you. What more do we need? All right, so this is a 30-minute workout. We'll do a little warm-up. We'll work from hard to breathless for about 20 minutes. We'll be in that zone, at 8 and 9, for 20 minutes. And then we'll come back down with a cool-down. So enjoy these first 5 or so minutes. Before we head up into that hard zone. Turn that knob in front of you until you feel like you've got a little something on the wheel. Connecting heart rate. I'm gonna watch what my heart does today. It's kind of a fun number to watch. So heart rate training, I think, is misunderstood. You know, it's been thrown around for a long time. Slow the legs a little bit and give me a little more resistance. Misunderstood because unless you go in and have a VO2 max test and you know what your heart is actually capable of, what your actual ranges are, the best you can do is the little math equation, 220 minus your age. And that's not a good, your age is not an indication of what your heart's capable of. To give you an example, so I'm 58, so I'm just gonna use the number 60 to make it math easy. If I did 220 minus my age, that would say that my maximum heart rate is 160. And then I would calculate my percentages down from that. And I would be working at this level all the time. And I'm capable of working way above this level because I've been doing this for a while. Okay, so when you train with heart rate, it's better, I believe, to go by how you feel. Instead of letting your watch or your console tell you how hard to work, work to how you feel in these zones and then look at the number. So it would be more like this. Okay, right now, this feels like moderate intensity to me. It's about a 7 on a scale of 1 to 10. It's not too hard. It's not too easy. Okay, so what is my heart rate when I'm working at what I feel is moderate? So try that on today. See how that works for you if you do have a device that shows you your heart rate. Don't let that be your boss. Your heart is the boss, and you're learning to pay attention and then just look at the reading after that. All right, just take a look and pay attention right now to where your hands are. And I want you to just move your hands slightly into a new position, just something a little bit different. Where they just were, that's probably your go-to. Just change it up a little bit. Use some different muscles in your hands, your forearms, your shoulders. Just change it up a little bit. Make your body wonder what's going on. We've got to adjust to something new. Let's add a little bit more resistance reach forward, stand up. Let's walk it out for about a minute. Still feeling moderate, right? But see if your heart rate went up a little bit as you stood. That's normal. Now look at where your hands are. That's probably where they always go when you stand. Change them just a little. Find a new position for your hands. Breathe in. Breathe out. All right, who is ready to go with me into the hard zone and stay there for 20 minutes? Raise your hand. Okay, because that's where we're headed. So let's be in this battle and we're gonna drop a little bit of resistance and we'll use faster cadence to get us up there. So put your hips on the back of the saddle. Find that new place for your hands. We're gonna try something a little different today. Change it up. You can pedal anywhere from 80 to 100 RPMs in this first little stretch. Notice your breathing. I'd like you to find 8 out of 10 hard effort. And if you feel like you're there, for me, what that means is my legs are starting to burn a little bit. I sound like this. I have to work a little harder to get that steady and slow breath. And it gets warmer. That's how I know I'm there. So now look at your heart rate. What does your heart do when you are working like this? All right, my friends, get comfortable here. In the uncomfortable, because as I said, we're here for 20 minutes. We'll change it up, we'll sit, we'll stand, we'll go slow, we'll go fast. But for right now, you're trying to be between 80 and 100 RPMs for a couple of minutes. Hard effort. If you're watching this and you habla español, I hope I'm not playing inappropriate lyrics. I'm playing Shakira today because I love her. And this is a really old album. And I don't speak very much español, so you'll have to let me know if I'm playing something inappropriate. Knowing her, she's talking about her hips and love and romance and dancing. All right, so your hands are in this new position. Wiggle your fingers. Shake out your elbows. Drop your shoulders. Loosen your neck. This new hand position might really shake things up in your body, just that little shift. Your body has to adjust. Just try to keep something slightly different going on. All right, try to keep your fast legs, your strong core. The next song, we're gonna slow it way down and put lots of resistance on. And let's just see the difference in our heart rate with faster versus slower cadence. Take a few deep breaths in through your nose, out through your mouth. This is you doing you, your way. You can get out in the world and do you your way the rest of the day. Take a deep breath, let it go. All right, grab a drink of water And let's get some more resistance on the wheel and slow these legs. All right, so down to our slowest cadence. 50 to 60 RPMs. I want you to dig in right here. Give me hard, solid pedal strokes. Add enough resistance that the beat of the music is just right for you to push into. Hips are on the back of the saddle, chest is lifted. Let's try to stand here for a bit, slow. It's a slow walk. Almost like you're hiking on something steep. Change your hands a little bit. Wiggle your toes inside of your shoes and shift your hips back. Let your sitting bones tap the saddle as you move from side to side. Core super strong. Deep breaths, everybody. All right, does this feel like hard effort? 8 out of 10. And if so, what's the number? What's the heart rate that shows up when you're working hard? Is it outside the range of what someone told you you should be? Go by how you feel. You can breathe, but this is hard effort. It's challenging. The whole body shifting from side to side. The whole body, not just the hips, the whole body. Change your hands just slightly. Fingers stay loose. Try not to get glued in one place. Deep breaths. Full body, side to side. All right, I want you to get familiar with this feeling of hard effort. In the next section, we're gonna work towards some breathless intervals. And I want you to feel the difference, this versus breathless. So we'll lose our breath and we'll come back to this. All right? Have a seat. Keep this. All right, so this is about 50 RPMs. What we're gonna do to catch these intervals is we're gonna try to pedal double the speed, or 100 RPMs. What do you think about that? Well, we're about to find out what you think about that. All right. So there's our slow. And when I say go, I'd like you to strive for faster. Closer to 100 RPMs. And you can let off a little bit of resistance to get there, but we'll come right back to this. Shoulders relaxed. Breath full. It should feel like hard effort still. All right. In 4, 3, 2, drop a little, speed up. See if you can get closer to 100 RPMs and you've got resistance on the wheel. That should be fun. Not fun. There you go. Settle in. Try to get closer to 100. Breathless is what we're looking for here, friends. Get up there on the edge. Beautiful. Stay here for 4, 3, 2, and 1. Gear on. Slow it down again. Woo. Okay. It's really challenging to go from breathless just back to hard when your body wants to go back to easy. Just come back to hard. Drop a little. Accelerate. Not fair, I know. We're not trying to be fair. Trying to be effective. Fingers loose, shoulders relaxed. We're here for 4, 3, and 2. Good. Add a little slow to hard effort. Not fair. Effective, yes. Find that new place for your hands. They're going to default back every time. Find a slightly different place. Breathe deep. Okay, folks, drop some resistance, pedal it out a little bit. Whew. All right, we have about 8 minutes left in the hard zone. Flush it out a little bit, and we're gonna settle in. This last 8 minutes is all climbing, just straight climbing. So as soon as you're ready, add resistance to the wheel. Find 60 RPMs. Make it challenging, but doable. Stand with me. I want you to make this a struggle. Hips are touching the saddle. Low belly strong. Struggle meaning, don't take the easy way out. Find resistance that challenges you. We're doing this together. You know we'll feel better when we're done. And right now you're in the thick of it. This is always where we want to back off, but we don't. We stay in the challenge and we get what we came for. So the hands are in a slightly different place. Can you bring your hips back 1 inch farther than you normally do? Try something different, slightly different. The body still moves from side to side. The breath is full and slow, even though you're working hard. Whew. Is there any tension in your shoulders? And if so, can you just take it out? Can you loosen that? Those hips still back about an inch behind where they normally are. Challenge yourself. Reaching those hips back causes you to have a longer spine. A little more core strength, a little more glute engagement. Can you stay standing with me for one more minute? Say yes. Okay, check in with your breath. Check in with how you feel. This is hard effort. 8, maybe even 8.5. What is your heart rate doing? If you see numbers, does that number match up with what you think it should for hard effort? Most important is perceived exertion, how you feel. Go ahead and settle back. Ooh, keep your resistance on. We only have one more work song. 4 more minutes, just like this. Hard effort. You should sound like me. You should feel like you're working really hard. Cool down is next. Your feet push forward before they push down. Find that new place for your hands. Wiggle your toes. Take a few more deep breaths. We are so close to the finish line on this one. How about on this last little stretch of hard effort, we close our eyes. Feel breath. Feel heart working. Feel legs. Feel hands. Feel feet. Do those slight changes make a difference? What can you do during the rest of this day to make some slight changes to your life? Something fun that I've been playing with lately is trying to do more with my left hand because I'm right-handed and we live in a right dominant world. So I've been trying to use my left hand a little bit more for day-to-day things. Just to change my brain. Maybe try that today. How many times can you catch yourself going to open a doorknob with your right hand and using your left instead, or vice versa? Go through a day carrying things in your dominant hand so you're forced to use that left hand. Try texting with your less dominant hand. It's fun. Folks, we're almost there. Got a couple minutes. Can you add? Can you put more on the wheel and finish strong? In through your nose, out through your mouth. As we come to the finish line, what's the maximum resistance you can have and keep 60 RPMs. What's the hardest you can push yourself for this minute? The resistance that causes calves to work, shins, quads, glutes, hamstrings, hip flexors, and core. That max resistance calls for all of it. Don't slow down. Give yourself a challenge right here at the end. Shoulders are relaxed. Hands are in their new place. As you take off resistance, do it with your less dominant hand. As you drink water, do it with your less dominant hand. Sit up tall. All right. Breathe. Woo. So fun. Let your arms come down. Shake out your hands. Get some circulation into those fingers. Keep the legs going with some resistance on the wheel. Open up your shoulders, palms up. Open and close your hands. And really reverse the wrists. Four, three, two, and one. Now add an elbow bend, reach out. Arms back just a little bit so your chest is expanding. Four more here, open and close. And then open, give yourself a hug, one arm on top of the other. Lift and lower the elbows. Find those shoulder blades. Remember which one's on top. Open, switch. Lift and lower. Open again, arms up, interlace, press your palms to the ceiling. Let your legs move a little more slowly. Cactus arms, squeeze those shoulder blades together, and then wrap behind. So your arms, your chest, your shoulders should feel amazing right here. Deeper breaths. Go ahead and stand up on your pedals, either foot ahead, and stand tall, press your belly and your hips forward, just so you can get a little length here in the front. And then shift from your hips, come down into hamstrings and drop your heels if you like for calves. If you want more, grab another short ride, put two together. Go ahead and switch, or just push pause right now, turn on your favorite music and go a little longer. Hips forward, belly lifts, chest lifts, and then hinge from your hips, come to a flat back, hamstring and calves. All right, my dear friends, you're amazing. Thanks for showing up for yourself. Be unique. Go out and change things a little bit today and have a fabulous day. Peace.